Well, bless the Lord. We're so grateful to be here tonight. And this is the Lord's doing. And it's marvelous in our eyes. We're grateful to God because on my best day, Isaiah 64 and 6 declares that all of my righteousness is as filthy rags. That you are standing looking at a jacked up preacher. I need God. I don't just want God. I need, come on, tell somebody, I need God. Yeah. So, I have to hear the gospel. I have to be in the house of God. I don't come to church just because I want to. I come because I have to. Because I need God. But I'm honored to be here to stand behind the pulpit of one of God's greatest generals who has... who has never bowed down under pressure, who has never compromised. And in the midst of everything going on in the world, he's still one of the few voices that is declaring the whole counsel of God. Can we honor God for Pastor? Come on. Come on, come on. Last time I was here, I think, was in December. Oh, you standing up there. Oh, praise the Lord. I brought some guys with me. They really doing it today. Praise the Lord. And but anyway, y'all, this is my father. This is my dad right here. That's my papa. Somebody asked him the other day, we were somewhere. They said, are you his real dad? He said, yeah, that's what his mama say. Praise God. Mama's baby, daddy's maybe. Praise the Lord. But we're glad to be here. And I really want you to hear me tonight. And trust me that this word that I'm giving you is something this morning I was, and I want to say this because this weekend I had the opportunity to be with Smokey Robinson and Barry Gordy and watch this. Even Donald Sterling of the L.A. Clippers, well, ex-L.A. Clippers. And but I had an opportunity, you know, sit down with these men. But I am more honored to be in the presence of the people of God, full of the Holy Ghost. And flying home this week, I like taking late night flights. I like praying while my enemies are asleep. And then if I'm in the air, that means I'm praying over the head of my enemies. So that's when I like to pray. And I just woke up this morning and the Spirit of God really spoke to me this very strong word. You know, I'm not an evangelist or a teacher or pastor. My assignment to the body is a prophet, and I take that very seriously. That means I dance to the beat of a different drummer, and I have to say what God tells me to say. But if you work with me tonight in the Holy Ghost, I believe the power of God is going to hit this place. And I know you've been having a great time this weekend, and I don't know why they made me last, but we're going to see what happens. Slap about three people around you and tell them God's getting ready to blow your mind. Hallelujah. I need the oil. I need thee. This is a camp meeting, y'all. Yeah. Breathe. My soul loves Jesus. My soul, hey, yes, Lord, loves Jesus. I'm trying to find worshipers and folk who come through that old womb of holiness where you had to travail in his presence and say, my soul, ay, 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 ay. Love Jesus. Come on. Bless his name. Keep it connected. Come on. My soul. Love Jesus. Everybody say, my soul. From your heart tonight, love. Get that before me. Jesus. My soul, come on, love Jesus. What you gonna do? Bless his name. He's a wonder in my soul. Everybody, he's a wonder. Yeah, 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 yeah. In my soul. What am I sanctified for? He's a wonder in my soul. What you gonna do? Bless his name. Another horse shot. He's a wonder in my soul. Hey, he's a wonder. In my soul, yes, Lord, he's a wonder in my soul. Bless his name, Church of God in Christ. Yes, come on, Cody. Come on, Mason's children. Yeah, 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 yeah. From your heart, yeah, 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 yeah. Cut out the music. Come on, yeah. Come on, use your voice. Oh. Clap your hand and tell him, yes, Lord. My heart says yes. My mind says yes. My will says yes. All of me says yes. From the top of my head to the sole of my feet, I give you a yes this morning. I give you a yes tonight. I give you a yes tonight. Say yes. Tell him yes, Lord.
Sit down. I didn't come all the way here not to have no church. I grew up watching Dominion Camp Meeting on TV. And when I used to watch it, they used to have some church. Y'all don't remember? Y'all remember R.W. Shambaugh? I remember. I used to watch it on TV. And people used to get healed and delivered and set free. And I come to tell you tonight that every bondage on you is going to be broken tonight. Hey, Shanda, get out of the whole Shantai. Yes, God. Would y'all sit down? Sit down, please. Please. I beseech you. Oh, Shantaba. Come on, please sit down. Please. All right. Sit down. Act like you got some sense. Be on your best behavior. We'll get wild in a few. I was looking at something the other day over there about how David danced. Hey, out of his, you know, ephod. You understand? And the ephod, Halabashanda, was not all of his clothes. A lot of people think David danced naked. No, he didn't do that now. That ain't God. Keep your clothes on. Jesus, come on. Jesus, call his name, come on.
Jesus,
say it again, come on, say Jesus.
Jesus,
come on, call his name, y'all.
Jesus,
I love to call the name of
Jesus.
Everybody call him Jesus.
Jesus.
Come on, lift your hands, say Savior.
Savior.
Come on, call him Savior.
Savior.
Sing it from your heart tonight.
Savior.
What's his name? Jesus.
Jesus.
If you need a healing, say healer. What's his name?
Jesus.
Come on, call him again.
Healer.
I feel that tonight, y'all.
Healer.
Healer. Come on, what's his name?
Jesus.
Now look up and say, thank you.
Thank you.
Come on, tell him thank you. Sorry, that just came in my spirit. Be seated. I want to finish. So David was, you know, he was shouting and acting crazy. And the Bible actually say that his wife talked about him because he was acting crazy. And can I tell you what God did to her? God cursed her womb because she made fun of a praiser. That's why if you praise God tonight and anybody start making fun of you, it's going to hinder them from producing anything. Now, I got to locate my praises tonight. Yay! All right, now listen, sit down. Would y'all sit down? And but as when they would praise God, you know, the linen ephod would not just cover their body, but it would cover their private parts. I wish you would catch what I just said. Because I want to let you know, if you praise God tonight, stuff that should be exposed, God gonna cover. You miss what I just said. Yeah, you miss what I just said. Some of y'all know you done did some stuff that you don't want God to uncover. But God said, if you praise me, I'm gonna make sure what should be uncovered be covered tonight. Sit down. Sit down. Sit down. Where's Ethel? Is Ethel Buchanan here? Ethel Buchanan, where you at? Where's she at? Let me go get her. Ethel Buchanan, stand up. That ain't the Holy Ghost, y'all. That's me. I know her. Okay. I want to let y'all know, you know, the Spirit of God didn't get at Timmy. You see this woman here? 7 years ago, full-blown AIDS, they gave her 7 months to live. I said 7 years ago. Y'all make me mad because y'all don't know what to shout about. Come here. I was in St. Louis, Missouri. St. Louis, where y'all at? Anybody from St. Louis? Hey, bless your heart. How you doing? I was in St. Louis, Missouri. And she came up to me in a service. And she said, Prophet Carn. I say, what? Y'all sit down. I say, what? She said, the Lord told me, I'm going to get healed in your service. I said, well, good. God bless you. He didn't tell me that, but he told her that. And so I had a Friday night service, awesome service. But then the Holy Ghost spoke to me and told me to do a Saturday morning worship. So the church was packed to capacity, about 1,500 people there on a Saturday morning, no preaching, no prophesying, just worship. The power of God hit the place. And when it hit, I had a little white, you got it over there, huh? Yeah, I had a little white towel that I gave it to her. And I just threw it on, I guess. I don't know. I'm going to get in trouble because I be stealing them from the hotel. You know, the hotel room. I'm just telling, I won't be free, okay? So set me free. I won't be delivered. Get this yoke up off of me. It's a spirit, okay? I need to be free. But, you know, it'd be the only thing around. So anyway, so I get it and I bring it. I take it back, you understand, but I take it away for a season. So anyway, and so so I had one and I wiped my sweat and I gave it to her and hit her and she fell out. And 7 months to live. 7 months, right? How did church folk treat you?
Like I had AIDS. Like I was dying of AIDS.
Bad?
Bad. They wouldn't hug me. They barely spoke to me. They shunned me. They asked my children when I was going to get my burial insurance. They asked my children if my children had made my funeral arrangements yet. But yet they were still telling me, we love you in Jesus' name and we believe God with you.
That was 2000 what?
Eight.
What happened?
September. September of 2008, I went to a service with Prophet Carn. God healed me right there in that service.
Well, how you know? How you know you're here?
I went to my doctor that next Monday. I spent 9 hours. They did test after test after test after test. They couldn't find anything wrong with my blood. So they thought that there was a mix-up in my blood. So they tested my blood again, and they sent it to the Center for Disease Control. The Center for Disease Control sent back a fax, and I gave the document to Prophet Carn years ago with the information stating that contrary to their previous findings, they could find no trace any longer of the AIDS virus.
Do y'all know when to shout? I said, do you know when to shout? I say, do you know when to... Wait. She said she went to the doctor, and the doctor didn't believe it. So the doctor sent her stuff to Atlanta, the Center for Disease and Control. She usually keep it with her. But I seen the paper, because I started acting crazy. I seen the paper where the doctor said, contrary to prior findings, we see no trace. Now that was 7 years ago. That means we were supposed to have a funeral in 2009. It's 2015 and she's still alive, because he was wounded for your transgressions, bruised for your iniquities, the chastisement. My God, somebody getting healed right now. You better receive your miracle. I dare you to jump up and shout like you know God is real. Hey, I dare you. Kaya, Shataya. Y'all said I. But I don't care what verdict the devil gave you. I don't care what the doctors told you. God brought you here this weekend because he's getting ready to change every report, everything they spoke against you. I come to prophesy, you will not die, but you're going to live. And you don't know when to shout around here, do you? What? This ain't my message, but I got to preach real quick. Look at your neighbor and say, neighbor. Come on, get the right neighbor, because the power of God about to hit this place real strong. I got to preach what God told me to preach tonight. But look at your neighbor and say, neighbor. The Holy Ghost wants you to know tonight, every negative word that's been spoken about you will be canceled tonight. I dare you to shout if you believe it. Come out! Hey! They dancing back there, y'all. I'm trying to find my dancers in here. Hey, whose side are you on? I'm on the winning side. Whose side are you on? I'm on the winning side. Whose side are you on? I'm on the winning side. Whose side are you on? I'm on the winning side. Tell your neighbor, whose side are you on? I'm on the winning side. Whose side are you on? I'm on the winning side. Whose side are you on? I'm on the winning side. Whose side are you on? I'm on the winning side.
All right.
Ezekiel chapter 13. Matthew 13. Yes, Shanda. Hallelujah. Everybody can't shout because the devil ain't been messing with you. But the only people that can praise God is the ones who've been under attack. And the devil gave you a bad report. I come to tell you that the devil is a liar. You better dance for your breakthrough. Matthew 13. Matthew 13. War cry, slow, come on. Oh, 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 come on. Wait. We're gonna try that again. That's you telling the devil, I'm not on the defense, I'm on the offense. That's you telling the devil, I'm not gonna wait on you to attack me, I'm gonna take care of you before you attack me. That's you letting the devil know whatever you done sent, I done already took care of it. Come on. Oh, 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 come on. Tell somebody, I got victory. Oh, 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 oh. You ready? Come on. I feel Shekinah about to come in here. Change it from an oh, and I want you to put a yes with it. Because all the promises of God are yes. Come on, say yes. Come on. Yes, yes, yes. I know the doctor told you no, but God said yes. I know the people at the bank told you no, but God said yes. I know they told you no and told you it wasn't approved, but God told me to tell you, you've been pre-approved for your breakthrough tonight. From the top, yes, yes, yes.
No.
Oh, yeah. I feel deliverance in here.
Come on.
Yes, 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 yes. Matthew 13, glory to God. Hallelujah. I say hallelujah. Matthew 13, I say glory to God. I say glory to God. Lepro studi bi apaya, vala di apasa. Yelela Bahasha, I say glory to God. I say glory, 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 glory. Glory to God, glory to God. I say glory to God. Yay! Yelela Bahasha. Somebody say glory to God. Somebody say glory to God. I'm not the priest, but somebody say glory to God. I don't know if you know it, but something just opened up in the Holy Ghost. I said, glory to God. Something just opened in the Holy Ghost. And some of y'all about to miss it because something just opened. I said, glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. I feel a breakthrough in here. I tell you, I say, glory to God. Glory to God. There's an anointing. I say, glory to God. Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God. Don't, hey, let us sow, brother, let us sow, let us sow. Glory to God, there's an anointing here. I say glory to God, glory to God, glory to God. I feel a release in here. I say glory to God. I feel a breakthrough in here. I dare you to slap three people and say something is about to break for you right now. Something is turning for you. Something is shifting for you. I said something just broke in here. I just felt a release. I just felt a release in the Holy Ghost. I said glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. Yes, Lord. Hallelujah. Matthew 13. Quickly. Thank you. Strings. Matthew 13. Glory. Come on.
You are.
seated in majesty. Come on, open your mouth. You are. For just a moment. Yes, Lord. Kalaman Shalavovo. Valadivas. Zevonunimia. Kiantorobo Kusha. Ye Bashanda. Hallelujah. Lift those hands. I got to preach this word. Don't mind waiting. I don't mind waiting. Don't mind waiting on the Lord. Before me, I don't mind waiting. I don't mind waiting. I don't mind. Matthew 13. Let's stand just for a moment for the reading of the word. Matthew 13. Draw me.
Draw me, draw.
Chapter 13, when you have it, say, I got it. Verse 24. Come out of there. Just flow. Softly. Matthew 13. Verse 24. He put another parable before them, saying, the kingdom of heaven is like a man sowing good seed in his field. Verse 25. Then while the men slept, his enemy came and sowed tares, darnel, in the midst of the wheat, and he left. When the crop sprouted and made fruit, then the tare was also revealed. Watch this. And when the servants of the landowner came, they said to him, Master, didn't you sow good weed in this field, good seed in the field? Where these tares come from? He said, an enemy has done this thing. Servant said, do you want us to gather it when we leave? He said, no. If you pull it up, you're going to uproot the wheat too. Let them grow together until the harvest. Then in the time of the harvest, I will say to the reapers, get the tares, bind them in bundles, and take the wheat into the storehouse. 1 Peter chapter 5. First Peter chapter 5, verse 8. When you have it, say, I got it. You don't have it, say, wait on me. Hurry up. First Peter chapter 5, verse 8. Be sober. Vigilant. Why? Because your adversary, the devil, goes about as a roaring lion, seeking whom he may devour. Father, we need you tonight. Anoint me to speak this word with clarity, with precision. I beseech you by your mercies, please. Don't give me yesterday's anointing and last week's anointing and last month, but I need something fresh. Someone came looking for a miracle, and you woke me up this morning and gave me this word. Give me the boldness to declare it and to speak to these nations that are watching all over the world and people that are here tonight. Let me speak with power. And let signs and wonders follow, because you confirm your word with it. In Jesus' name. Hug about three people as you sit down and tell them, I'm excited about your future. I'm excited. Boom. Thank you. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. Hopefully you can bear with me tonight. I want to minister a word tonight. And I trust that if you're here on this Sunday night, something in you believes possibly that God does talk to me. I want you to hear me. Just listen. I want to minister a word tonight entitled, There's been a security breach. There's been a security breach. In 2009, you know, this couple named Michael and Tarek actually crashed Obama's first state dinner. Was not supposed to have even gotten in there. Were not even on the list. But because of Secret Service's irresponsibility, people uninvited were able to come into the White House. And the Secret Service said that the reason it happened is because they never even checked to see if their name was on the list. In 2011, a man outside with a semi-automatic rifle shot at the White House. Shot for some time, but another Secret Service man said, "Don't pay it no attention. It's just a car shooting fire." They did not know that it was actually a semi-automatic rifle until one of the house cleaners was cleaning the White House, and in one of the girls' rooms, the glass had been broken from the bullets that were shot. 2012, 8 Secret Service agents went on a trip to Colombia. You remember? With the president, and when they were supposed to be protecting the president, they were instead having prostitution meetings when they should have been protecting the president. They were indeed doing something they had no business doing. 2014, the Secret Service again, after a night of too many drinks, one of the people who was a part of the counter assault team, which is the last line of defense for the protection of the president, was found in the hallway drunk, which made it easy for the enemy to come in. The Spirit of God began to speak to me after this terrible law was passed all across the country that has told the church, that has really been a slap in you Christians' faces, telling you no matter what you believe, no matter what you think, we say that marriage is between two hairy men. The devil is a liar. I became alarmed about this thing that happened because I didn't understand how did this happen on our watch. When Amos chapter 3 verse 6 declares, "Shall evil come in a city and the Lord God have not done it?" When 2 Chronicles 7:14 declares that if my people which are called by my name would humble themselves and pray, seek my face, turn from their wicked ways, then will I hear from heaven, I'll forgive your sin, and I'll heal the land. However, this thing was able to creep upon the church. You that was around me, you that looked on my website at the beginning of the
year, I gave some prophetic words that God gave me for 2015. And one of the things that God told me was that the homosexual agenda was going to flourish. And that's why here in Columbus, Ohio, you got to stand behind this church and this ministry. You got to stand behind Word Harvest Church because you have a pastor that was willing to stand in the face of the president and tell him marriage is between, y'all ain't talking back to me in here, it's between a man and a woman. God is getting ready to raise up preachers who will not compromise but will declare the whole counsel of God. So the Holy Ghost began to speak to me, and he said, son, the reason these things are able to take place, I said, this should not happen. 25% of the world is evangelical. You understand that? Here's the problem. 13% of the 25% of the evangelical audience now believe that it's okay for two men to marry, when the Bible declares that if a man lay with another man, it's an abomination. We cannot get around it, but everybody is preaching everything else. How are we preaching this old feel-good stuff when the devil is taking over our country? He's taking over your children, and you come into church shouting and dancing, and the devil is after your child. God spoke to me. He said, son, I want you to preach harder. I want you to preach harder against homosexuality than you've ever preached before. I said, why? He said, every time you preach against it, I send an angel to protect your family from it. I come to tell you, declare what God said, declare. So I asked God, would y'all sit down? I asked God, I said, Lord, why is this happening? And the Lord said to me that the reason this thing was able to occur is because there has been a breach of security. I say, what do you mean? He said, the enemy has snuck in. He crept in unaware. I said, well, how did this happen? He said, the first place where there was a breach of security in your Bible is when Lucifer, yes sir, when Lucifer there was a breach. What do you mean? The Bible declares that Lucifer was an anointed cherub. Yeah, he was perfect in all of his ways. Lucifer was not any kind of man, but Lucifer, he didn't need a praise and worship team because he was worship. His very body embodied every instrument. The only instrument that he was not able to get was the brass section. He didn't get brass because brass is symbolic of royalty, and God doesn't share his glory with nobody. Yet Lucifer, he didn't need a praise and worship team. He was the praise and worship team. The Bible says he was perfect in all of his ways until iniquity was found in him. There was a breach there. I was sitting down talking to Phil Driscoll. We was having a conversation, and he was talking about this situation that occurred, and he said, listen, he said, the way that God was able to detect, the way that God was able to detect that iniquity was in Lucifer, I said, how, Lord? He said, I heard it. I said, what? He said, I heard it. He said, and by the time I caught it, a third of the angels had already been affected. You missed what I just said. You got to catch this, because the first place where the breach has taken place is in our praise and worship. I got to talk to you. See, the reason we got the homosexuality in the world is because we got homosexuals singing in the choir, and don't nobody want to say nothing. And when the worship ain't right, the people can't be right. Look at, we got these people singing in the choir who hands ain't clean and their hearts ain't right. And the Bible says, who shall abide in my holy tabernacle? He that have clean.
clean hands and a pure heart. But now we got people who are singing. They're not singing for the glory. They're not singing for a manifestation of power. They're singing because they want money. Everybody come to church for a gig. And when they get done singing, they leave and they go back to their hotel rooms. Why? I'm looking for the praise and worship leaders that didn't only just worship when they had the mic, but worship when you don't have the mic. Am I getting on y'all nerve yet? There's a breach. Slap somebody and say, there's a breach. There's a breach. Come on. Come on. Tell somebody there's a breach. Look at our praise and worship today. You can't tell the difference between godly songs and worldly songs. And the enemy's creeping in on the church because musicians are slowly sneaking secular chords into gospel music. And now you got young folk in church dancing and juking and jiving like they in the world, when the Bible declares there must be a difference between the clean and the unclean. I know you don't want to hear this. I know you want me to shout you, but the devil is a liar. He's after America. He's after this city. He's after this state. And God is about to send judgment on the nation of America. But in the midst of the judgment, there's a people that God is getting ready to raise up, full of the Holy Ghost and power, going to pray, that's going to cast out demons, lay hands on the sick. If you want it, jump on your feet and shout glory. Tell your neighbor, there's been a security breach. Come on, tell somebody, y'all sit down, please. There's a security breach, and it happened first in our praise and worship. That's what happened, y'all. Our praise and worship changed. Most things that we call praise and worship, it ain't worship, because you sing about him, but you're not singing to him. Worship is not singing about him. Worship is singing to him. I listen to some of these gospel songs. They make me depressed when I listen to them. I need gospel music and worship song that's going to love on him, that's going to adore him. But nobody wants to worship anymore, because everybody want to dance and shout. Your flesh want to be on exhibition. Y'all ain't saying nothing in here. But the hour cometh, and now is, where the true worshipers of God are going to worship him in spirit and in truth. That's what we need. We need some worshipers that don't care about a title, don't care about a platform. If they got to lay on their face, they'll lay on their face. If they got to go crazy, all they want to do is worship. Slap somebody and say, don't mess with my worship. Don't mess with my worship. You got the wrong neighbor. I said, tell somebody, don't mess with my worship. How dare some of y'all come to church and sit next to these people that act like you coming to church and doing God a favor. All the hell he done brought you out of. All the stuff he done delivered you from. And you gonna sit there with your arrogant self and won't worship God. I'm looking for people that know you should have been jacked up. You should have been in the crazy house. You should have lost your mind. I owe him my worship. Slap three people and say, I'm a worshiper. I'm a worshiper. Come on. Come on, tell somebody, I'm a worshiper. That's what I am. I'm a worshiper. You may not like me, but I'm a worshiper. You can't stand me, but I'm a worshiper. You know why I'm here? I'm not here because I'm talented. I'm not here because I can do everything right. But I'm here because I know how to touch the heart of God. I know how to get on my face. I know how to be like David and say, against thee and against thee only have I sinned. I'm looking for people that know how to worship God and say, God, you're my everything. I stand in awe of you. I'm addicted to you. You're the hot sauce to my collard greens. Y'all ain't saying saying nothing to me. You're the syrup to my biscuits. You're my midnight rendezvous. I live with you. I walk for you. Everything I am because of you. In you I live. In you I move. In you I have my being.
Please, 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 sit down. There first was a breach in the praise. The breach in the praise was something that I talk about all the time. Folk get tired of me talking about it, but I keep messing with it because I see the church is full of it. It's something called pride. Pride. He that exalts himself shall be abased. But if you humble yourself under the mighty hand of God, in due time, he will exalt you. Pride. Lucifer didn't want to praise God. The Lord said to me one day, he said, son, if you don't praise me, you'll praise yourself. When a man of God say lift your hands and you sit there and look cute, you operating in pride. See, pride is sneaky. You really want to know pride? Read Job, the 41st chapter, when it talks about the spirit of Leviathan. Yeah, he's the father over the children of pride. His strength is in his neck. That's what pride do. Make you walk around with your neck up. Like you got a reason to be proud about something. When on your best day, you jacked up. You're not supposed to lift your head. He's the lifter of mine head. That Leviathan, the Bible say, the scales are so tight on it that no air can get in. That word air literally means no spirit. Yeah, no ruach, no revival can come in. The reason revival can't hit our churches is because we're too proud. We want to be in control of the service. We want to tell God what to do, when to do it, what time to do it, when it. Y'all ain't saying nothing here. It's amazing how we tell God to have his way, and when he gets ready to have his way, we want to tell him to stop. The devil is a liar. We need a move of the spirit where people are tired of church as usual and will say, if it's all night, it's all right. Give me God. Come on, look at somebody and say, I want God. I want God. Come on, you ain't talking to the right neighbor. I said, shake somebody's hand like you trying to shake it off and tell them, I want God, baby. You can have the house. You can have the car. You can have the money, but give me God. Because if I get God, the money gonna come. If I get God, the house is gonna come. Seek ye first the kingdom of God. There's been a breach in our praise. A lot of this stuff we call praise ain't real. Some of y'all be dancing and praising and be looking at who looking at you. Eyes open the whole time. Sit down somewhere. You in the flesh. When you praise for real, you don't need no beat to praise God. You don't need no music to praise God. You got joy bells ringing in your soul. Yes, sir. I feel the Holy Ghost about to hit this house. I feel a move of the Holy Ghost about to hit this city. God's about to send revival. I need about 500 people to jump up on your feet and shout glory to God. There was a breach in the praise first. Because there was a breach in the praise. Are y'all still with me? Now there's a breach in the pews. Because the Bible says that while men slept, the enemy came in and sowed tabakashia, tares among them. Yeah. I want to talk about this wheat and this tare. I know a lot of people teach that they both look alike. But really, wheat and tare does not look alike after they are full grown. They only look alike in the immature stages. Okay, you missed what I just said. Some of y'all still look like the world because you immature. Yeah, I know you don't want to hear that. Yeah. You say you saved, but you get mad every 5 minutes. Yeah. You say you saved, but you're easily offended. Y'all ain't talking back to me in here. I know you don't want to hear, but I'm going to get that devil up off of you today. I'm going to get you to stop shouting over that mess you got in your life and come to the altar and get that mess up off of you. That spirit that got you thinking you're all right when you meet it in a junkyard dog. Don't nobody want to talk to you because you nasty and you call yourself saved. Tell me something. You believe in the baptism of the Holy Ghost with evidence of speaking in tongues. Well, let me tell you what I believe in. I believe in the baptism of the Holy Ghost with the evidence of speaking to one another. Y'all ain't saying nothing. Because some of y'all speak in tongues and won't talk to me. How you going to speak in tongues in church and then soon as we get out of church, you act like you don't even know me? You have a form of godliness. See, we don't talk about that. We preach on fornication. We preach on adultery. All of that sin. We preach on smoking. We preach on drinking. All that sin. But we don't preach on you mean church folk. You just mean and nasty. Uh-oh, I ain't done. Let's talk about you schizo church folk. You love me on Sunday, can't stand me on Monday, cuss me out on Tuesday, don't want to be bothered on Wednesday, speak to me Thursday. I bind that old schizophrenic demon in here tonight, and I command you to be free. Am I getting on y'all nerves? Y'all sit down. Huh? See, judgment is coming. I say judgment is coming. And the Bible says judgment shall begin in the house of the Lord. See, people don't understand what's getting ready to take place. Everything that's happening in the world right now is preparing us for the judgment that's about to begin. God is getting ready to separate the saint from the ain't, the clean from the unclean, the holy from the unholy. You hear all these preachers preaching, tell me something, they love God, and if it costs their life, well, we're going to see if you will preach this when it costs your life. When they tell you that if you preach on homosexuality, they'll put you in jail. I want to see if you'll still preach it then. And I must say something, and I know what I say is finna make some of y'all mad. Y'all gonna get offended with me. They sent me an email. Praise God, when I was on the television, they told me I was insensitive. But I'm gonna say it anyway. You don't like it, just get delivered. Let me tell you this. It is not a testimony. This is nothing good. And I'm gonna say, I don't care if you get mad at me. It is not good that a sinner was able to walk into God's house and shoot the people of God up, and nobody had discernment to detect the enemy. I
I know you don't want to hear, but I'm going to preach it anyway. One thing about them old mothers, they didn't do a whole bunch of shouting and screaming, but they would sit there and they would discern, baby. They say a devil is in here some way. And let me say something else going to make y'all mad. It's a shame that those preachers let the president on the pulpit the same day that he sanctioned same-sex marriage. You don't want to hear, but I'm going to preach it anyway. He wasn't worthy to stand in God's holy pulpit. The devil is a liar, but we got a breach of security. There's been a breach. The enemy is walking in. You know why? Because everybody want to be friends with the president. I love Obama, but if he don't repent, he going to hell too. Now shout now. Shout now. And see, you black folk, y'all can't say I'm racist because I'm black. You can't say I'm racist because I'm black and I'm proud. But when it come to God, it ain't about no color. It ain't a skin problem. It's a sin problem. I'm going home. I see I done made somebody mad. But we need somebody that's gonna tell the truth. We need some preachers that got a backbone and ain't jelly back trying to be friends. The devil is a liar. I'm looking for the real soldiers. I'm telling you, it's about to get bad in America. You ain't seen calamity. I knew it was gonna happen when our president banned Netanyahu. You don't understand. God treats America how we treat Israel. When you disrespect Israel, you open yourself up for the judgment and the wrath of God. You think that church shooting was something God told me every church that don't have the glory is about to get robbed. I don't care what kind of security you got. The only real security is the glory of God. Except the Lord watch the city, the watchman waketh, but in vain. God's about to send a revival. There's a move of the Holy Ghost about to come to the church. There's a people that are tired of church as usual and are saying, give me the glory. Give me the anointing. Give me the power. If you want it, shout hallelujah. Sit down. Can I have 10 more minutes? 10 more. 10 more. 10 more. Can't even detect the devil. Folk ain't got no discernment. Can't detect the devil. Yeah. We so busy looking at your pocketbook. We so busy trying to be friends with you that nobody ain't praying no more. The church used to have shut-in prayer. The church used to go on fast. You want to know why? Because we knew that our adversary, the devil, was going about as a roaring lion, seeking whom he may devour. I'm not just preaching to y'all. I'm preaching to me. Because the Holy Ghost spoke me the other day. He said, son, you done got distracted. And some of us in here don't want to be honest. But we get distracted with social media. We get distracted with television. We get distracted with ministry. And we lose our secret place. We don't call on him like we used to. That's what I came to Columbus to do. I come to tell you here at this Dominion Camp meeting that if we're going to see the power of God again, we got to fast like we used to. We got to go back to the altar. Who am I talking to in here? That'll say, man of God, whatever it takes. If I got to kill it, I'll kill it. If I got to drop it, I'll drop it. Whatever the price is, I'll pay it. Because I want his glory in my life. There's been a breach in our praise.
There's been a breach in the pews. Huh? Sow tares. Wheat. Same place while men slept. Church, you sleep. That shooting in Charleston woke you up, didn't it? Everybody's scared now. Everybody's scared. But your adversary is not Dylan Roof, the man who shot them people. He's not your adversary. He's being used by a spirit. Here's why folk don't get mad at me. I ain't making it into a black and white thing. I know that's what they want you to do, but righteousness exalts a nation. Proverbs 14:34. Sin is a reproach unto any people. Somebody ought to be able to discern. Huh? There's an enemy in the camp. Certain things, Kakashia, shouldn't get to Pastor Parsley. Y'all quiet. Because somebody should be able to stop it before it get to him. Certain attacks as he's going through shouldn't get to him. Because the prayer team is praying and not lollygagging. Y'all ain't saying nothing. We need real intercessors. A lot of y'all call yourself intercessors. You ain't no intercessor. You just come together and have a whole bunch of gossiping. Ain't nothing but a Jezebel spirit. But I break every Jezebel. Are y'all hearing me? Somebody ought to be able to detect the enemy. Are y'all hearing me? Before he shows up. How he sneak up on you. Well, you don't understand. When you got the Holy Ghost. I've been talking about the Holy Ghost a lot lately. But when you got the Holy Ghost, you got an advantage. I feel the anointing coming on me now, y'all. I say when you have the Holy Ghost, you got an advantage over the natural man. You could see things that other folk can't see. Y'all ain't saying nothing. What you mean? A woman can walk on your job and you can say, baby, don't go get around her. She's a witch. Y'all ain't saying nothing here. When you got discernment, you can tell your baby, I can't tell you who to be with, but I can tell you don't mess with him. I can smell a dog a million miles away. Y'all ain't saying, when you got the Holy Ghost, there's a breach. I know y'all ready to go home, so I'm gonna get out your way. There's a baba shaka. There's a breach in our praise. I'm done. Pastor Bryant, there's a breach in the pews. But there's a breach in the pulpit. That's what I want to talk about. I want to talk about these old jellyback preachers. I want to talk about these preachers who won't say nothing to the president. I want to talk about these preachers who get on Oprah and compromise. Y'all ain't saying nothing in here. Yeah. Yeah, there's been a breach in the pulpit, and I got to talk about it because the Bible declares that there are ministers of Satan who have transformed themselves into ministers of righteousness. For marvel not, for Satan himself is transformed into an angel of light. Now, I know I'm going to get in trouble for what I'm about to say. You know, they tell me, you a young man, you ought to be careful. You shouldn't say the things you say. And they probably right. But let me tell you something. I
I'm used to preachers who held up a standard. I'm used to preachers where the Bible said, be not many masters, for yours is the greater condemnation. I'm used to preachers that wasn't trying to be superstars. All these preachers want to be on reality TV now. God ain't told you to be no star. It's all right, I preach it anyway. You don't want to hear what I got to say. I might be talking about your pastor. Just tell him to come get delivered too. Look at somebody next to you and say the Bible is right. But there's been a breach. There's been a breach. There's been a breach with our preachers, because nobody wants to pay the price and nobody wants to be hated. The Bible say, marvel not if the world hates you because they hated me first. You remember when you first got saved? Your family didn't want to be around you. They didn't want to hang with you because they knew something about your life brought them under conviction. Yet I look at these preachers. They inviting all these stars of their service, and ain't none of the stars getting delivered. They leave the service and go right back to doing the same old thing. The devil is a liar. I don't care what nobody say. If you are in Christ, you got to be a new creature. Old things are passed away. Behold, all things have become new. I need you to shake your neighbor next to you and say, neighbor, 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 neighbor. Come on, don't play with this thing. I said, shake them real hard. Turn me up just a little bit, y'all. I said, shake them real hard and say, neighbor, we need a revival in our pulpits. We need some preachers that can lay hands on the sick, that can cast out devils. We need some preachers who can cause the blind to see, the lame to walk, and the dumb to talk. We need a move of the Holy Ghost. And if we're going to see revival, we got to stop these feel-good messages, and we need to preach a message that bring people under conviction, that's gonna make people go after God. If you want God, shout hallelujah. Preachers, our responsibility, the secret service responsibility, is to guard the president. Preachers, our responsibility is to guard this pulpit. We don't let everybody preach in this pulpit. I don't care how talented they are, you don't let them preach. Because a lot of them ain't preaching nothing. Y'all ain't saying nothing. The time will come where men will not endure what? Sound doctrine. But God called us to guard it. But now we let everybody up there. Y'all quiet. Anybody that can move a crowd. Anybody that the people like. The Bible say that when people like you, you abomination in the sight of God. Ain't nobody supposed to like you when you go to preaching and telling them you can't lay up with your boyfriend and go to heaven. Y'all ain't saying nothing here. Y'all ain't saying nothing here. Ain't nobody gonna like it when you start telling folks you can't say you save and voting for people that's totally against your God. You ain't gonna shout no more, are you? You ain't gonna shout no more, are you? I knew you weren't gonna shout no more, because you see, y'all just got mad at me. Y'all vote race, but God told us to vote the world, the principle. And let me tell you something, we not in the world. We in the world, but we not even of the world. We're not even bound by this world, sister. Y'all sit down, I'm coming. I'm almost done. Because I know I done made y'all mad. But somebody got to tell it like it is. Somebody got to call sin, sin. They told me the other day, they say, Prophet Carn, all you do is preach on sin. That's all you do is preach on. I said, well, you don't know what it is until you put a label on it.
Am I making sense? You can't do what you want to do. And when you preach that, people ain't gonna like you. And a lot of us preach on stuff till it hit our house. Y'all quiet. See, a lot of preachers will preach on homosexuality until their son become one. Then they won't talk about it no more. Y'all quiet. I only got one night. I gotta let, you know, I gotta get it out. I prophesied and I told them that the homosexual agenda was gonna flourish. Any of y'all that was around me, any of you seen on the website, you saw it. I prophesied and I told y'all that a spirit was gonna hit America that was gonna make everything go feminine. I told you that even the clothes for men were gonna turn feminine. Now look at it, look at it. Now they got men dresses. Ain't no real man gonna put on no dress. The devil is a liar. I told you. And you ain't seen nothing. Lord spoke to me and told me that that happened in South Carolina. He said it's about to be copycats. Lord spoke to me the other day. He said two more major preachers are about to die. You know, that man up there in Charleston was a preacher. But Lord spoke to me and told me two more major preachers are going to die, and this is what he spoke to me. I saw a flood hit Atlanta, Georgia. Now, you know, I'm talking about a flood like, remember how bad Katrina was? I saw a flood like that hit Atlanta, and it was so bad that it made people start moving to Augusta. Judgment about to hit this country. Judgment about to hit this country. And you folks sitting around here, you sit up in these churches with no power. You sit up in these churches and go there because your mama went there, your daddy went there, your grandma went there, and you're going to grandma yourself right to hell. See, we playing with it. It's a game now. And when you preach like this, they say you're old school. They say you're judgmental. You're mean. You ain't got no mercy. The devil is a liar. Everybody want to preach grace. I don't have a problem with grace. But Jesus did not just come with grace. He said grace and truth. See, they preaching grace, but they're not preaching truth. Truth is, you can't live like you want to live. Are y'all hearing me? I'm not compromising. I'm not going to compromise to be nobody's friend. You don't got the liking, but I'm going to tell you something. Somebody is hungry for God in this place. There's somebody sitting in your seat saying, this is the kind of preaching I miss. There's somebody sitting in your seat saying, this is the kind of preaching I need to hear. Who am I talking to? That's saying, man of God, I don't mind being encouraged every now and then, but I need a word that's going to drag me to the altar. There's a breach. They dress like preachers. They look like preachers. They talk like preachers. They got a Rolls Royce body with a lawnmower engine. They look very good. They say all the right words. But no yokes being destroyed. If you preaching, there's no conviction. Ain't no need in you preaching.
Hello, 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 hello.
I said, if you preaching, ain't nobody getting delivered. You need to throw your mic away. Y'all ain't saying nothing here. Too many folk coming to church demon possessed. And when demons manifest, instead of us casting them out, we call security. The devil is a liar.
I'm done. Mark my word. The last year of Obama's presidency, if he's watching, will be the worst year of his life. God said that this next election will be one of the most confusing elections we've ever had. That something is going to happen this next election that has never taken place before. God said that Ahab and Jezebel would rule for two terms. Came to pass. He said the next spirit that take the seat will be Athaliah. Go home and study Athaliah. She was a queen that killed whoever she had to kill to get in power. Lord spoke to me and said, these civil outbreaks that you saw in these other states, you ain't seen nothing. Something is getting ready to hit Missouri again. That bad thing that happened in St. Louis, is something about to happen there again. You've not seen it. What's coming upon this country? I know people say to me, they say, well, you always telling you the bad. Well, saints got to understand. When I tell you the bad that's coming, that's when you need to be shouting. Because it ain't for you. He's not appointed us to wrath. Y'all ain't talking back to me in here. It's coming. Yeah, yeah, yeah. It's coming to the world. But I come to tell saints, arise, shine, for thy light is come, and the glory of the Lord is risen upon you. Let me say it Dominion Camp style. Behold, I will do a... I need you to shake somebody next to you, and I want you to shake them real hard and say, neighbor, 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 God's about to do a new thing. God's about to send a fresh move of the Holy Ghost. Things are getting ready to happen that never happened before. I know it's been dark. I know it's been bad, but I come to tell somebody, be not weary in well-doing. God's getting ready to blow your mind. Get out your seat. Go run to seven people and say, get ready. Look at somebody and say, it's about to happen. I said, look at somebody and tell them it's about to happen. You got the wrong neighbor. I said, tell somebody it's about to happen. You still got the wrong one. Find you somebody and say, neighbor, it's about to happen. You're getting ready to walk in the greatest season of your life. God's getting ready to take you places that you've never been before. God's getting ready to call you to walk in an anointing that you never walked in before. I come to tell somebody in here, it's time for you to get excited, because while everybody's losing their mind, he's gonna keep you in perfect peace if you keep your mind stayed on him. I come to tell somebody, he that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. I want you to grab your neighbor. I need you to rock them and shake them. Shake them and rock them. I said rock them and shake them. I said shake them and rock them. And say, neighbor, the Holy Ghost has you going through what you're going through.
because what's getting ready to happen, you're going to have to be in prayer. So he sent you through the trial. He sent you through the storm. He sent you through the rain to get you back on your knees. But when you come out, there's a fresh anointing that's going to rest on you. There's a fresh power that's going to rest on you. I come to tell somebody, you need to get ready to walk in an anointing that you never walked in before. I need you to do me one more favor. I need you to walk real quick. I need you to take 3 steps. And I need you to look at your shadow, because your shadow is getting ready to heal the sick. Your shadow is getting ready to raise the dead. Be not weary in well-doing, for in due season you're gonna reap if you faint not. I come to tell the church, get ready for God to do a new thing. God's getting ready to sit some people down, but he's getting ready to raise up a people that's hunger for God. It's your time. It's your season. It's your hour. You get ready to prophesy. You get ready to walk in power. Get out of your seat. Go run to 5 people and say, get ready, get ready, get ready, get ready. Tell every devil in my house, get out of my house. I won't be satisfied until all my children be filled with the Holy Ghost. I won't be satisfied till every cancer in my body is healed. That's what I want. I feel the anointing. I feel the glory. I feel power. Somebody scream. Somebody. Get ready. I dare you to shout one time. I'm done, y'all. But before I leave here, I want to give you this word. And I want to let you know that the things that are going on in the country right now is God calling the church back to a place of intercession. It's not time for you to just be playing church. It's not time for you to just be going to church. But God is getting ready to raise up a group of people that's like Queen Esther, that'll say, if I perish, let me perish. I'm going to see the king. God is getting ready to raise up a bunch of people that's gonna be like Peter. Silver and gold have I none, but such as I have, give I unto thee. In the name of Jesus, I command you to get up and walk. God, God, God is getting ready to raise up people that's gonna be like Job and say, though he slay me, yet will I trust him. God is getting ready to raise up people that's gonna be like David, that'll say, create in me a clean heart and renew in me a right spirit. God is getting ready to raise up a people that'll turn off the television, that'll turn off your cell phone, and'll get on your face, and'll be like Jacob. I'm not gonna let you go until you bless me. I'm not gonna let you go till you deliver my family. I'm not gonna let you go till you you say, my son, I'm not gonna let you go until you heal my body. I'm not gonna let you go until you bring me out. I need you to grab one more neighbor. This is your last time, but I want you to grab your neighbor and grab them real hard. I said, grab them real hard. And I want you to do me one more thing and say, neighbor, just like I'm holding your hand, I want you to hold on to God's unchanging hand. It might get rough, but don't give up. It might get tough, but don't give up. Be not dismayed, whatever be tied. God will, I feel my help now. God will, I feel my help now. God will, he gonna take care of you. This is the best season of your life. The devil should have killed you when he had the chance. He should have took you out when he had the chance. But the Holy Ghost told me to tell you, by September, I'ma blow your mind. By September, I'ma take you places you never been before. Don't wait till the battle's over. Shout, 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 shout. Look at somebody and say, it's about to happen. Tell them it's about to happen. Tell them it's about to happen. I've been sent by the Holy Ghost to get rid of the breach of security. I come to call the church back to alignment. It's time for the prayer warriors to get back on the altar. It's time for the mourning women and the cunning women to weep at the altar. It's time for the preachers to get back on the altar. It's time for the people of God to call on God like never before. Because I'm telling you, it's gonna get so bad, they gonna tell you not to preach in his name, but neither is there salvation in any other name but the name Jesus. What profit is it for man to gain the whole world and to lose his soul? These preachers got money, but they don't have power. They got houses, but they don't have power. But if you in this room and you're hungry for God, I dare you to shout like you done lost your... Shout! Shout! Shout America, shout for your city, shout for your children, shout for your husband, shout for your wife, shout for your family, shout, shout, shout. I said shout.
I just heard something. Move that up to the... I just heard something. It's about to get wild in here. And if I was you, I wouldn't leave right now. I said, if I was you, I wouldn't leave right now. Because you don't know what God want to give you. There's a couple in here
Your last name is McCarter. Where are you? McCarter. 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 It's a couple. Come here. Just a woman. Come here, woman. Well, come here, Pat. You come with her. How y'all doing? You good? Join hand. Karabasan. Yeah. Well, your name is right there. Because the Lord told me, he said your name was Anthony, but you don't have a name tag on. He told me your name was Cheryl. That's your name? Lift your hands. Don't do that. I'm still at church. Don't go to the funeral on me. They be ready to go to funerals. Don't let's stay at church. The power of God finna come on you. And God said a double portion is about to visit your ministry. God said your coming here was not in vain. But everything you lost over the last 5 years, he's about to give it back to you. Take some of y'all better shut. You better shut. You better shut. I say y'all getting on my nerve because y'all don't know when to shout. I said, if you in this room, I know this is crazy, but if you in this room and you're hungry, come on, push me. I said, if you in this room and you're hungry for a deeper depth and a higher height and you want God desperately with every fiber of your being, there's an anointing in here that's about to be released. There's a fire that's about to hit your belly. There's a glory that's gonna come on you. Some of y'all about to get drunk. Run to this altar. I said run to the altar. I said run to the altar. My God, come on. Receive the anointing. Receive the anointing. Receive the anointing. Receive the anointing. Hey, come on, come on. Hey. 1, 2, 3, 4. Come, quick. Move this out the way. Hey, bye. The power of God on you, baby. The power of God on you. Power of God on you. Hey, power of God on you. Yeah. Lift your hands, the anointing is here. I said if you're hungry. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Come, hurry. Brother, that's yours. That's yours, brother. Receive that anointing. Hey! Hey! Brother, that's yours. That's yours, brother. Receive that anointing. Hey! Hey! Yama! Hey, shout out. I feel an anointing in here. I feel a glory in here. There's power on you, brother. Power. Hey, shout out. I said the glory of the Lord is in the room. I said glory of the Lord is in this room. The glory of the Lord in the room. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Come. Hey. Fresh. Hey, Shandaba. Hey, Kia. Power of God. Hey, ho. Somebody shout in here. What? Lift your hand. Lift your hands high. Lift your hands high. This ain't for everybody. Lift your hand. Lift your hand. It's not for everybody. It ain't for everybody. Because everybody don't want to pay the price.
But lift your hands if you're hungry. Come on. Lift your hands. If you're desperate, come on, close your eyes. Get your eyes off of me. Get your eyes off of me. Get it off of me. Lift your hands. Lift your hands. We need a move of God. Come on, reach up to it. Reach up. Lift your hands and reach out.
your hand, something is pouring out. Come to the ocean. Yay. 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 Come on, Zion. All over this sanctuary. Cry out to God.
Reach up, Levosha, Mandolobo, reach up, Shekomo, Salidibi Andova, Rabababobosha, Lendelelebe Ota, Kandilibi Ohosha, yay, 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 Olala Babasha, Yande, Yolobohosha, give it to him, Kondolobosha. Yababaya, yay, Shata, the anointing of the Holy Ghost comes on you now. I'm looking for you that are desperate, you that are hungry for more. Hungry, hungry, hungry for more. Yeah, bababaya, yeah. Come on, shay, shay, lebosa. Come on, you that are hungry for more. Come on. Yelabaya Shando. Ula la baba. Kotola baba basha. Hey, yelebo. Raba taya. Koshande. Hey, hey. Libanzo. Come on. Come on. Hungry. I'm hungry. I'm desperate for more. I need more. I need more. I need more. I need more. Hey, Shama. I need more. Shando. Yala la baba ya ya. I break it. Receive tonight for more of God. I'm desperate for more, for more, for more. Hey. Lift your hands. Lift your hands. Every eye closed. Every hand uplifted. Every eye closed. Talk to him. Tell him you're all I need. Come on. Come on, the Bashande. Yay, la la bo 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 sha. Kian la la bo bo suri di bie. Come on, Jesus, I'm desperate for you. I'm desperate for you. I'm desperate for you. Reach up to him. Come on. Come on. Yandilibi Ohosha. Javolobo Salubi and Telebe. Lebrando la la basu kuribiate. Come on. Lift your hands and I
say, ah, come on. Tell them I'm lost without you. Come on, church. With everything you got, come on. Lift your hands and say, ah.
Lift your hands. Lift your hands. Ha, ha, ha. Every eye closed, lift your hands. Miracles are happening right now. Lift your hands. Put your hand on that sickness right now. Right now. Kulobosha. Kuloboshandelebe. Lanini me onzolo lobo yo kuli biatara. Lebrosu ni bi onziri bi usta. Vali bi ase komi aba. Kalabanda ya. Lift your hands. Lift your hands, the anointing is here. Ha, 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 ha. There are stomach ulcers being healed. There's a stomach condition. Be healed in Jesus' name. There's somebody's left ear, it just popped open. I give you praise. On my right, there's a cataract on the right eye. God's healing it right now. There's a gum disease. That's the best way I can explain it. The Lord's healing that now. Lift your hands. The anointing is here. Receive that. Come on, receive your healing. You don't have to wait on me to call it. Just receive it while it's here. That's right. That was a lung condition just healed. I give you praise.
Somebody has a condition in your lungs. The Lord's healing that now. Unable to breathe, be healed in Jesus' name. Leave your hands. There's another asthma just got healed. I give you praise. Leave your hands. The anointing is here. The anointing is here. The anointing is here. Alabosa. Pastor Parson, if you don't mind, I just want to lay my hands on you very quickly. If you don't mind, lift your hands high. Shemosa. Mandolobohokoya. Iribiosha. Yes, Lord. For your glory. Kalibosa. Kalibosa. Malibiapola. Yalobosa. Zalalobolibiohosha. For your glory. Power of God. Whoa. Kasha, as you don't leave, as you, I want you to do one thing the Lord said to me. As you return to your seats, when I count to three, I want you to hug seven people, and I want you to hold them when you hug them. And all I want you to say to them is, I got to have his glory. When I count to three, you're going to hug seven people as you return to see. But I want you to hug them and hold them. And I want you to tell them, I got to have his glory. That's all I want. One, two, three. Go ahead. Do it now. Hug them and hold them. And hold them. Got to have them. Hug them and hold them. Yay! Yay! Shandama! Yalababababa!
Baba. Shande. 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 Bella. Valendio. Olola Mandio Shama.
I want you to hold both hands of one person quickly. Hold both hands, one person. Look at him. Look at him. Hold both hands, one person. And look at him. Look at him. Look at him. You're looking at a glory carrier. You're looking at somebody who's been crushed. You're looking at somebody who's been through some things that if it wasn't for God, they would have lost their mind. Come on. Squeeze that hand. And look at him, Mashande. Yes, God. I said, squeeze that hand. Andilimini Oshnai. Squeeze it. Squeeze it. Look at him. And say, neighbor, if you only knew the glory that you were carrying, you would understand why the enemy does everything he can to stop you, to block you, to hinder you. Even the attacks that came against your family were not for your family. They were actually for you because of the glory that you carry. But God told me to tell you tonight. God told me to tell you tonight. Every attack, every
sent you is going to wish they never touched you, because the glory of God is about to rest on you and your children. Now shout if you believe. Quick, there's a gentleman in here. Your name is Richard. Your last name is like a your first name is Richard. Your last name is like a Blummerfield. Where they at? Stop right there. Just stop. Lift your hands. This is your hour of visitation. The Lord shall visit you, and he shall visit your house. I see the number 76. I don't know if that's where you live, but I see the number 7. Make sense? Address? 76? All right, lift your hands. God's going to meet you at your house. This is your hour.
Yay!
Of visitation. Lift those hands high.
The Lord spoke to me very clearly. I know you've already given. I'm in one of the greatest, I was saying season, and the Lord spoke to me and said, don't say season, call it an era. So I'm in one of the greatest eras of my life, because season's in, but I'm decreeing this one ain't gonna end. Say amen. In the last 2 weeks, God had one man send me an email and say, I need to talk to you. He said, I'll give you $25,000. I said, I didn't pray for long. I called him, and I gave him the word of the Lord that the Lord told me to give him. He had already gave 10. Then he gave another 15. Then I hung up, and after I hung up, he gave another 25. That's 50. Then a day later, he gave 67,000. That's 107. And then he said, come to Miami, I have a check for you. This is after he mailed a check for $375,000. And then after he mailed that check, he said, come to Miami, I got another check. My daddy said, what'd he do? I said, none of my business, praise God. Somebody told me, well, what if that's filthy lucre? I say, when I pray for it, it's blessed. Praise God. That's 375,000 check. Then when I got there, he said, the Lord told me to give you this check. And that was a check for 500,000 just in the last 2 weeks. because I was in a service and the Lord spoke to me and told me to give a seed to somebody who I didn't really think the Lord would. He took me there. The Lord told me to sow a big seed to Billy Graham. I said, good old brother Billy. I said, I need to give him some more money. Praise God. But the Spirit of God told me to do that. And the Lord said to me, he said, son, you've entered into a realm that whatever you touch, I'll sanction. Now listen. You don't have to believe God talks to me. I don't care. Some of you might watch me on Daystar channel. When I got on the air and I prophesied and I told y'all in the month of April, our earthquake was going to hit. I said it's going to be one of the worst earthquakes we had in the world. I said I wasn't sure if it was going to be in America or what. I said, but God said an earthquake was going to hit. In the month of April, just like God said, that earthquake hit in Nepal. God spoke to me the other day and told me there's getting ready to be another shocking death. Like, remember what happened with, like, Whitney Houston or Michael Jackson? Something like that's going to happen again. The Lord spoke to me and said, something drastic going to hit America in the month of September. Lift your hands. If you think I'm here because I want something from you, keep it. The last thing I need from you is money. But tonight, I know you've given. I know they pray for you. Well, there's a miracle going to be released for 50 people in this room. There's every bit of 4,000 people in this room today. Six, I accept. And there are 50 people in this room. Somebody asked me the other day, they say, why Pastor Benny keep playing you on this program? I'm going to tell you why. It ain't because I'm all that good. I gave Pastor Benny a word, and I said, Pastor Benny, in a service in California. I said, Pastor Benny, the Lord said give $1,000. He said, Brian, are you sure? I said, yes, Pastor. I said, give $1,000. And the Lord said, tomorrow, a woman named Linda is going to give you $100,000. He said, Brian, if I don't get it tomorrow, I want my $1,000 back. I said, yes, sir, Pastor. He sold the $1,000 seed and the next day went to West Palm Beach and a woman named Linda wrote him a check for $100,000. Last time I was here, we pulled the lever. Y'all remember that? Remember money coming to me now? A woman was in here, gave that $77 seed, and supernaturally, y'all remember, $110,000 showed up in her account. God, a bad boy, church. Slap somebody and say, my account is next. Lift those hands high. But I want to do something, because Acts chapter 10, an angel visited Cornelius's house and said, your prayer and your alms has come up as a memorial. The Lord said, the seed you sow tonight is going to release an angel to your house. Lift those hands high. As high as you want them to bless you. Close your eyes and get 5 people in your family in your head that you really want to see God deliver. 5 of them. There are 50 people in this room that God told me, if you don't believe it, keep your money. If you think it's a game, keep your money. No gimmicks around here. This is a holiness church. But there are 50 people in this room. As sure as I am that God told me that man was Richard, as sure as I am that the Lord told me that woman's name was Cheryl, is as sure as I am that there are 50 people in this room that the Holy Ghost is challenging you to sow into this ground. Matter of fact, it's 49 of you because I'm going to be the first. Who would I give a seed? Somebody say, I already gave. Okay. Well, maybe I'm not talking to you, but there are 50 people. And all you have is 4.5 minutes. God said you're the sow seed of $1,000. And this is what he said to me. For me to lay hands on you, and it's going to release an angel to your house. Think it's a game? Keep your money. The rest of you, all 49 of you, you got 4 minutes to meet me at the front of this church. It is so. Quickly. Straight line across. Shalaba. Quickly. 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 Trust me, if I was preaching for money, I wouldn't preach the message I preach today. Because this ain't no money message. This message make people mad. I'm gonna say something crazy. There's one person in here, I know it like I know my name. God is challenging you to give a $25,000 seed. One person. I was in Alabama. The Lord told me to tell one man to give $5,000. And I told him God was going to give him $5 million. And in 7 days, God gave it to him. There's one person in this room. God is telling you to sow a $25,000 seed. One person in here. I don't know who you are, but whoever you are, I got to lay hands on you and speak over you where the Lord told me to do. It's one person. Lift your hands high quickly. The anointing is here. The anointing is here. Kasha, 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 Sheka Kaka. Lift those hands high. You in the audience. I wouldn't miss this for nothing in the world. Somebody sitting in your seat, they say, it's already 50 people up there. I ain't coming. You crazy. Get on the overflow. Praise God. Glory to God. Somebody say, glory to God. Come on. Come on. Say it like Jesse the Planets and Kenneth Copeland. Come on. Say, glory to God. There's one person. God is telling you to give $25,000. Tonight, it's just one of you. And this seed of $25,000 is about to change your life. That's what the Lord just said to me. You don't believe it? Keep your money. No pressure. Lift those hands high, high, high. The rest of you in this room. The rest of you in this room. The rest of you in this room. Anywhere in this room. Anywhere. Anywhere. Anywhere in this room. If you have $40 to your name, not 40 that you want to give, $40 to your name. You got 2 minutes that whatever the closest aisle is to you, get in it quickly and make a straight line all the way back quickly. Quickly, 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 quickly. Move quick. You don't understand. Giving triggers the prophetic. When you give, it looses the mouth of God. Yay! Just put them in the closest aisle. Straight line all the way back. Single file. You know, like you was in school. Yellow bossa, salibia.
Now, I want to do this right because,
real soft.
Straight line, the $40 seed, straight line all the way back. Who's giving that seed of 1,000? Raise your hand. Raise your hand high. You giving it tonight? I don't want you up here acting like you're giving it if you're not, because you're lying to the Holy Ghost. And you going to hell. How many folk know that'll send you to hell? Ananias and Sapphira did what? Lied to the who?
Holy Ghost.
That's right. You didn't lie to me, but you lied unto God. Hey! God is real. I need you to tell everybody around you, God's about to visit your family. Yeah, ba 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 no. I said, tell somebody around you, God's about to visit your family. Le momosha. Shalimi apala. Excuse me. Sandalo boho koyasha. I said, tell somebody, God's about to visit your family. Come here, brother. My last name is Carn, but you're not going to make the check to me. Make it to World Harvest Church. All right. She said, young man, what's your last name? Lift your hand, sir. I'm going to take my hand and put it in the lower part of your back. And God going to give you a miracle in your spine. Shut your hands toward it. Can you hold my mic, brother? Hold to my mouth. Shalabasa. Your sleeping habit's about to stabilize too. You're not going to toss and turn. There's a young man heavy on your heart you've been praying for. God said, I got him. This is your hour of visitation. Father, give this man the miracle he needs. Restore him. Everything he lost. Hosha. There it is. Hey! Lift your hand. Halabaya. There it is. Shanda. Lift your hand. There it is. Hey. Lift your hand. If I be a man of God, the Lord spoke to me and told me you went through something just about a year ago where the enemy tried to attack your health, but God said not so. If I be a man of God, the Lord told me to tell you, I told you to write a book some time ago, and as you, when you get done writing that book, God said you're going to begin to see my hand move. You got a gift of healing in your life. When you lay hands on sick folk, they get healed. That's why the enemy fights you tooth and nail. But this is your hour of visitation. God said, that young lady you've been praying for too, you're about to see my hand move in her life. This is your hour of visitation. Shut your hands toward this woman. Right now, as I minister to her, there's a condition with her nerves, where the enemy attacks her nerve, like she get this pain that goes up her back. They call it like a sciatic nerve. But tonight she's healed by the power of God. I say she won't. Y'all get on my nerve because y'all don't know when to shout. I say she's healed by the power of God. Ain't God real? I say she healed. Lebrosturibiada. I say she healed. I want you to, I want you to take your hand and put it right here. Not y'all, just her. Come here. Shut your hands toward this woman. This woman need a miracle. She been up under so much stress and she ain't told nobody about the enemy literally trying to get her aneurysm in her brain. Somebody close to her passed away and she's still grieving from it, but tonight she healed. Tonight she healed from it. Tonight she healed. Lift your hands. Tonight, we need that coat right there, brother. I'm sorry. Praise the Lord. She healed tonight. I say she healed tonight. Don't walk close on me. I say she healed tonight. I say she's healed tonight. Lobosha. We believe God. I say we believe God. I say we believe God. I say we believe God. We got to get out of here because I feel this thing turning on, you know? It's turning on. But I want you to tell one more person, God's about to deliver your family. God is about to deliver your family. God. You healed tonight, brother.
I fell several years back and hurt my back.
He told me, he said, I want to let you know. He said, I've been dealing with sleep apnea. He said, and I fell some years ago when I was having a problem with my back. He said, you're right. But tonight, he's healed tonight, y'all. I said, he's healed tonight. Yay! I said, God's real and he's healed tonight. I say, y'all get on my nerve. I say God real and he healed tonight. Yeah. He's healed tonight. God's about to visit your family. The enemy been after your family tooth and nail. But not so. I say not so. I say, not so. Lift your hands. You got on that yellow. God's going to give you a miracle. Let me tell you what I saw. I saw a stronghold that came from your mother's house. This spirit causes you like to be in a relationship, but they never succeed. You give your all, but you come out unhappy. But tonight, you're going to be healed. God going to break this thing completely off of your life. Shut your hands so on. Shut your hands on. Not only that. She has a bitterness in her heart. She has a bitterness in her heart. She has a bitterness in her heart. She has a, hold my mic for a breath. She has a bitterness in her heart towards a man. But tonight, God's going to set her free. There it is. There it is. There it is. I said, there it is. The power of Jesus. There it is. Lift your hand. Stand on your feet. Lift your hand. I don't know what that is about that business, but God told me to tell you I'm about to open that door. Everything you've been trying to do, the finances you need to start, what you're trying to start, he's getting ready to put everything in your hand. He told me to tell you he ain't forgot about you. There was an accident where you could have lost your life, but God spared you. When I lay hands upon you, God said he's going down your hip. It's like when you get out the bed, your hip always catch a little problem, but you're not going to have that no more. You're healed tonight. The Lord told me to tell you this is your hour of visitation. Shut your hands on. You went through something. You went through something at a workplace, but tonight God giving you strength, he giving you peace, and everything you lost, he's going to give it back to you. Lift your hands, sir. I don't know you from Adam. I never met you in my life. Stand on your feet. But I'm going to pray for you because not once but twice you could have lost your life, but God spared you. I'm looking at you about when you was about 30-something years old, God covered you and spared you from something. You ain't even supposed to be alive. When I lay hands upon you, God told me to tell you what your father dealt with and what your grandfather dealt with, you're not going to deal with. God said you're going to be the curse breaker. It ain't going to come nigh your dwelling. When I lay hands on you, he giving you a brand new heart. God told me to tell you, you ain't gonna have no heart attack. Hey, somebody shout in here. Y'all need to shout. Y'all need to shout. Hallelujah. Lift your hands. Lift your hands. Y'all ready to go home? Yes, you are. Lift your hands. Hallelujah. It won't what? You want me to pray for? It won't? Well, lift your hands. Lift your hand. Halabasa. Ain't God real? I said, ain't God real? I said, ain't God real? I said, ain't God real? Lovosa. Zavu vivi viele via passa. Le prondu ribi Christi bi utara. I'm coming, ma'am. Young lady right there, you got your hands up like that. The hand of the Lord is on your life.
You've been chosen from your mother's womb. You have a gift upon your life for God to give you the ability to feel the infirmities of people. It's like when other people weep, you'll weep. When other people cry, you'll cry. I'm going to lay hands upon you tonight because I see an attack where the enemy going to try to send a distraction your way. But God going to put a wall of fire around you. Come here. Lift your hand. Don't we serve a God that's real? Sir, I don't know where you're living. Now, y'all together? Y'all together? I want you to go home tonight. I want you to pack your bag and put it in a closet. I don't know where you're living, but God said you're getting ready to move from where you presently are. He's about to expand your territory. The Lord told me to tell you. I saw you make a move, and you thought it was going to be something you like, but you end up not liking where you were. But the Spirit of God said, I'm about to expand you again. And when I say you're making a move, I'm not just talking like a move from a house to house. There's going to be a geographical move where God's going to send you to a whole nother city from where you presently are. The Spirit of God says where you are, they tolerate you, but they don't celebrate you. He's getting ready to place you around people who won't take advantage of you, but I love you. God also told me to tell you, lift your hands. I feel the anointing. God, I release that on her life in Jesus' name. God also told me to tell you, Yelema Salimi Filidiata. Yeah, I'm going. I know y'all ready to go home. I'm ready to go too. Praise God. Will you hold my mic for me? Hold it to my mouth, okay? Because the people I brought with me, they ain't moving. Praise God. I'm going to lay hands on you. And I see Shamufala, a spirit hanging on your back. That every time you put a seed in the ground, it eats your seed. And that's why it looked like every time you give, like you don't never get a return, because there's a seed-eating spirit that came from a woman, Malavosa. I saw a woman close to you in your circle. Remember the name Denise. Whoever this woman was delving in witchcraft. And the Spirit of God says she saw your prosperity, became jealous of it, and sent a spirit to hinder your blessing. But the Spirit of God say every demon of witchcraft has been broken tonight. And the power. Yay. Yay. I would do anything. Lift your hands high. I want you to hold your seat up high in the air. Hold it up high. Hold it up high. Shaba. Hold it up high. Shant. Oh. Korabasa. Hold it up high. Be healed. Be healed. Shaba. La ba 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 ba. Thank you, Jesus. Ye, Kosha, Father, I break this yoke up off of her. I break this yoke up off of you. Come on. Come on. Lift your hands, church. I feel a deliverance in here. I said, I feel a deliverance. Lift your hands. Lift your hand. Alamasa. You want me to pray for you? Yes, ma'am. I'm going to pray for you. In the name of Jesus. In the name.
How?
Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Lift your hand, church.
Hold your seat up in the air for the next 30 seconds. I want you to believe God
to touch your family. Yeah. You need an angel sent to your house. Shika. You need an angel sent to your house. You need an angel sent to your house. What happened to you? Okay. Are you able to walk at all?
So what it does? So when you walk, what happens? How long? For how long? Back that chair up, y'all. Now, y'all, when it comes to the miraculous, you know, like, when the Lord speak to me and tell me to pray for somebody, I pray for them. You know, sometimes you may want prayer. I want to pray for you, but I wait to hear his voice. Set up just a moment. Now, you say when you walk, usually you'll fall. Lift your hand. The Spirit of God said this thing that came against you is spiritual. I know you gave a whole bunch of medical explanation, but spiritually, I saw in the realm of the spirit a demon. This demon had legs, but the legs were crippled. On the leg of the demon, I saw the name like Madeira. I don't know what that was. Lift your hands. But the Spirit of God spoke to me and said, when I lay hands upon you, this stronghold that has been upon your life, I need the church to shout for 30 seconds right now.
Wait.
I saw a demon. The legs were crippled on the spirit. But on the legs of the demon, I saw the name like a Medina. Did y'all hear me say that? What's your name?
Nadina.
Lift your hands. When I lay hands on you, God is crippling the demon that crippled you.
Pow!
There it was.
I need y'all to shout. Pick her up. Ma'am, come here. We gonna walk. We walk. I command you right now, be healed. I command your body, line up, walk. Come here. Come on. Walk. I need y'all to shout because the power of God is about to come on. Come on. Walk. Move that wheelchair. I said, there it is. God's healing them. Strength is coming. Somebody praise it. Look at her. She's healed. Y'all ain't shouting. Y'all making me mad. I said walk. Somebody shout. The power of God is all over her. Somebody scream. Walk with her. Somebody scream in here. Scream. Hey, Shama. Hey. All right. Lift your hand. I'm done, y'all. The anointing is here. Be healed. Lift those hands up. Koshama. Lebrosturibia. Kalaba. Lift your hands. I need a mic. Lift your hand. Shelelebe onzoyara. Livusu uva zaziza. Lebrosturibi Christibi untakasta. Lekadobi ashtabaya. Venunimi anzaya. Poya. Kalala hosha. Brother, I don't know you from Adam. I've never met you. But because you honored God, and gave that seed that I asked of. You honored him in secret. God shall reward you openly.
I see in the realm of the spirit. I saw a barrel. In the barrel, I see a whole bunch of people. At the top of the barrel, I see an angel. The angel has a cord coming from his hand. The hand of the angel with the cord, or a rope, is given to a man who looks like you. And that hand, on top of the hand, I see like the name Stephen. Shalibio sanuna mapaha. Follow the vohosa. Ikandia. Pick him up. I ain't done. Shalabai. Follow the vohoya.
What's your name, sir?
Stephen.
Lift your hands.
And beside that rope is ropes pulling people out. Pulling them out. God said, you're the Joshua of your family. You came out. Now get ready. Your mama too. Hey! Y'all getting on my nerve because y'all don't know when to shout. Hey! Hey! Shabbat, I pray. Hey! Wait. Hold your seed up in the air, everybody. We're going to sow this seed in faith. In faith. You don't just give. You got to give in faith. Yele Moshe.
Stephen. Holla on. God a bad boy. Lift your hands.
Don't you love Pastor Parsley?
I say, don't you love Pastor Parsley?
Holla la ba 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 ba.
Lift your hand.
The Lord told me to tell you right here, this couple, right here, you don't have to pray another prayer as it pertains to your family. If I be a man of God, I saw one of your children look like the enemy got his hand on, look like you're just fighting them tooth and nail. But God told me to tell you, I sent them through this for the last 2 years to prepare them for the ministry that they're going to get ready to operate in. God told me to tell you this is your hour of visitation, and he told me to tell you, you will not bury your child. Hey! Alamaya! The Talamanda Hosha! The Kaya! Hey! No! I prophesy that on you. You will not bury your children! Hey!
Hey!
Lift your hands. Hold your seat up high. Y'all, the Holy Ghost is here. The Spirit of Truth is in the room. Hold your seat up high in faith. For the next 30 seconds, I want you to declare in the atmosphere, and I'm done. I want you to declare in the atmosphere. Neil, make sure you got my card. I want to give 1,000, okay? I want you to put it in the atmosphere. Everything. You got family members that you really need God to deliver. I dare you, in the next 30 seconds, you're going to call their names out. You hear me? In the next 30 seconds, you're going to pray wherever you need God to send an angel. If it's your address, call out your address. If it's to the hospital, call the hospital. Wherever you need the release of an angel. When I count to three, yeah, I want you to get ready. Are y'all ready? Are y'all ready? Now, this is something I want to do one more time. Who's giving that $1,000 seed? I want to see who you are. I don't want you to act like you're giving it. If you come up here and lie, you ought to go to hell. You're lying to the Holy Ghost. Amen. What's up? Who's giving that $1,000? Raise your hand. Let me wave at me. Count. You one. Say two. Say it loud.
7, 8, 9, 12.
If you already counted, put your hand down. 15. Count loud now. 32. I want heaven to hear your number. 32. Once you count it, put your hand down. 33.
34.
36.
37.
38.
Loud.
39. 40.
Good number, brother.
41.
42. 43. 44. 45. Count loud. 45. 46. 51.
53.
There you go.
54. 55. 57.
58. 60. 61. 62. 63. 65. 66. 67. 68. 69. Wait. I'm 70. Okay, hold on. Excuse me. I want to be the number 70. 70. Okay, go.
74.
Wait. How you doing? You raised me when I was a little boy. I remember you, Sister Pollard. How you doing? You had a daughter named Latoya. Chantoya Lowe. How she doing? I'm sorry, y'all know like when I was a little kid. Okay. 77. 80, 81, 83. I like your accent. 83, 84. 86.
87.
No, you 80. He was 88. You 89. Yeah. 90. Loud. 92.
94.
95.
97. 1,000. 101. And Pastor Parsley is 102. Is there somebody else? Giving 1,000? 102? 102? Well, yeah, wave at me. If you didn't count. If you didn't count. Huh? 103? 104? Come on. 105? Anybody else? 106? Come on. Who else? Huh? 107, okay. 108. 109. 110. 111. 112. Where you from? Jamaica. 112, that's it? Where you up there? You supposed to be down here, disobedient. 113. 113. Clap your hands for Jesus, y'all. Lift your hands high. I just want to let you know, the Lord told me that there was one person to give that seed of 25,000. God brought it to pass. They gave it tonight. Come on, give God a great big hand. Come on. There's another person giving the seat. There's two people giving 25. Y'all don't know when to shout right here, do y'all? Lift your hand. Lift your hand, sir. So shall it be. So shall my word be. Where you from? Ethiopia. Salam.
Salam.
Salam. Salam, sir. Shava. That's all I know. Praise God. That's all I know. Aye. Everybody come on, say.
Aye.
Come on.
December, you don't know what Aye means. But Aye is something they sing in Ghana. Where you from? You're Ghana. It's in Aye.
Aye, Bako, Yako, all right.
Really? Okay. It's a song they sing, which basically means, Lord, you so awesome. I can't come up with a word to describe it. So all I can say is, Aye. So the next time you don't get hit in that accident, say, Aye. The next time that sickness don't kill you. These are your people. Hold your seat up, please. Lord, I challenge people to give because I believe it's right. As long as the earth remains, seed time and harvest. Somebody's giving tonight who can't even afford to give. But they trust you tonight. I ask you tonight, please, 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 please cause the seed to multiply. Please. Good measure. Press down, shake it again. Lift your hands, church. This is one of the most anointed offerings I've ever took in my life. Jesus. I release an angel to their houses right now. I send Michael to fight on their behalf right now. Bless your people because they're sowing into good ground. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Aye. Aye. You're going to bring your seed. You're going to bring your seed and you're going to lay it at the altar. When you lay it at the altar, all I want you to say is thank you, Lord, for sending my angel. Can you do that? I mean that. The seed is going to multiply. It's coming back, y'all. You don't need me to touch you. Heaven has already touched you tonight. Everybody's going to lay your seat at the altar and you're going to say, Lord, thank you. Thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you for sending my angel. Bring your seat. Lay it at the altar now. Make sure you give it an assignment and thank God for sending your angel. Ah, yeah, come on. Ah, yeah. Come on, bring your seat, lay it at the altar. Ah, yeah.
with the short hair. Lift your hands. Stop right there. Just lift your hand. Take the baby from her.
Alabosa.
Alidi Bianca Lolobo Yitidi Asha. Ekalabasha Kalabasia. Glory. Slap three people around you and say, God is up to something.
Yeah.
Now don't go 2, 6, 2, go 2, 3, 4. Come on. Ah, yeah. Ah, yeah. Ah, yeah. Ah, yeah. Come on. Ah, yeah. Ah, yeah. Come on, Keshiva. Lift your hand. Now, so you see, led at the altar, let me tell you a secret. Just because you stand up here, that don't mean I'm going to prophesy to you, okay? So, you know, some of y'all think if you just linger around, that's going to make me talk to you. No, just bring your seat, led at the altar, and if I'm supposed to say something to you, I will. Hey, Shanda Bahaya. I don't know who I'm talking to, but I want to tell somebody around you. Tell somebody around you, God is getting ready to blow your mind. Your feet is about to go places you've never been before. Some of y'all are discouraged because it didn't happen yet. But look at somebody say, I can't wait till September. I'm telling you, September, God's getting ready to, every debt you owe, he's going to pay it off in September.
Hey, come on.
Your hand. I want you to hear me, and this may sound so crazy to you, but I just want you to be very prayerful of any individual that you're dealing with, because I see, as it were, in the realm of the spirit. A news flash. I see it on TV. On the TV, I see the name Amber. But when I saw it in the news flash, the name Amber, the news flash showed it to me. I need y'all to shut your hands to water. I saw you missing. I wish I had praying people. You know, God reveals to redeem. Look like you love your baby there. But the enemy is trying to take you from her. I see it. On the news, missing. Amber Carter. That's your name? What's your name?
Amber Carter.
Lift your hands. But you're in the right place at the right time. I wish I had praying people in here. Y'all, The effectual fervent prayers of the righteous. I need y'all to stretch your hands toward her. And for the next 30 seconds, I need you to intercede and travail that the plan of the enemy be disrupted for her life. Come on, pray, pray, pray. 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 I bind every demon of kidnap, every yoke of abduction. Hey, break up. Come on, y'all, pray, 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 pray. Alabasha, Ekolomosia. Lift those hands. Yendelele bidi bidi di alabasa. Zabu bibi 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 asha. Kalabosa, sevomanga. Lebrosu bibi ataya. Yes, Lord. Malabasha. The Holy Ghost calls you a prayer warrior. He calls you a woman of intercession. God said he gonna wake you up again at 5 and 6 in the morning, and it shall begin to speak to you and give you the mystery of the kingdom and things that are to come. And if you give yourself the prayer and fasting, you've seen my glory in a measure, but now you're gonna see it in a greater measure. For the Spirit of the Lord said, as I speak to you right now and I minister to you right now on the inside of your stomach, seemingly there's like a little lump that the enemy wants to make it into like a little fibroid tumor. That's why when you eat some foods, you have a problem with your digestive system. But tonight, you're healed by the power of God. I declare to you this day, you shall see my glory. For you've seen it in a measure, but now you shall see it in a greater measure. And my glory, palavadiba, shall be revealed. Malavosa, lift your hand. Heleba. Kalule be our time. Here be our shine. In Jesus' name, I accept. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Kora ba shine. Yay. Hallelujah. Say, aye.
Aye. Aye. Aye.
Come on.
Say, aye.
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 Aye. Aye.
Your hand, for you ask for the nations and I'll give it to you. I declare to you that you've seen me bless you in times past, but now I'm gonna bless you again. And I declare to you that a door shall open under you that will cause you to travel back and forth, back and forth, back and forth. For the Spirit of the Lord said you traveled once, and God said that you've been in one place, but in the days to come there shall a strong apostolic grace rest upon you. Well, you will not just have a church, I see building on you and planting on you. And the Spirit of the Lord said again, you'll travel back and forth, back and forth, back and forth. For prepare yourself, for I shall do it, and nothing shall be able to stop it. For I'm looking at some acres of land that you've looked at, and you said, God, I would love to have that land in my possession. And the Spirit of the Lord said, I'll place it in your hand, and I give you favor. And people will wonder, how did you get that? But it would be as if I put a mall into your hand. For I'm looking at a plaza, seemingly a plaza, but it's not just a plaza, it's a long plaza, like a long stretch of shops that you've desired. And the Spirit of the Lord said, I'm going to give this thing to you. Give yourself the prayer, for I made your mother a promise as it pertains to you, and the promise that I made to your mother, you will begin to see it come to pass. For your mother was a woman who gave herself, gave you to me. And the Spirit of God said, because she gave you to me, you belong to me, you are mine. And I even saw you went through a season where they tried to put some things on your name and tried to defame you and come against your character. But the Spirit of the Lord said, you outlive it, and I'll raise you up. And I declare to you that the state of Georgia shall be very favorable to you in the days to come. For the Spirit of the Lord said you'll travel back and forth, back and forth, back and forth, and you'll see my hand revealed in a greater dimension, saith the Lord.
more, for this is your hour of visitation. And I declare to you, you said, Lord, I have the people, but I need the help. I declare to you that God is sending you the help, for you've carried the load, but now God said the load is being removed. And God said, I am exposing every Absalom that seemingly has been in your camp. For I saw over the last couple of years, seemingly someone came and caused a split. But God said, for everything you lost, you shall see a restitution of all things, and my glory will be revealed. That's the word of the Lord. Hey, y'all better shout. I say shout. I say shout. Everybody, say I am.
Will rest upon you heavily. God will talk to you in the nighttime. It will be as if you will look forward to going to bed at night, because God will speak to you in the nighttime. I want you to remember the name Ashley, for I saw, as it were, in the realm of the spirit, God connecting you to a young lady. Her name will be Ashley, seemingly a friend of yours. And the spirit of God said, this Ashley, in the days to come, God will use you to be a strength to her, and she'll be a strength to you. I cover you from every trap, every snare, every plot. But I saw in the realm of the spirit, in the days to come, a trap shall arise, and it shall come through the name of an individual named David. The spirit of God say, run and don't look back, but I'll keep you, I'll sustain you, I'll protect you. For a strong prophetic grace will rest upon you. Dreams, visions, dreams, vision. Yasha, dreams, kabishta, kabishta, kabishta. Le banzanuni fili di ataya. Le prostudi bi krivis tele bi kataya. Makadoya. Ha 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 ha. Lift your hands. Yes, Lord. Come on, say yes, Lord. Come on, say yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Thank you for putting up with me. I know I stay in church all night, but I love you. Y'all pray for me. I'm starting a consecration tomorrow because I have a big meeting coming up in August. And Pastor Parsley's doing the first night, as a matter of fact. And But we have over 4,000 people already registered. Had to shut it down. And it's going to be awesome. But next time you see me, I'll be about 20 pounds lighter. Because I'm going on a good fast, a good one. When I fast, I don't eat nothing. No food, just water. Then I could really see. I could see where you was last night, you know what I mean? Yeah. So, but I love you so much. You pray for me, okay? I don't know if you kind of got caught up in the shout and missed the word tonight, but I hope you got it. That there's been a breach of security. But there's a people that God is getting ready to raise up who are going to guard his glory. Tell three more people around you. All I want is his glory. I love you so much. Pray for me.